getting away with what has been done to me. This is so atrocious, and it's probably one of, from what I've been, other people have told me, including my therapist, that this is one of the worst cases of systemic abuse that they've ever seen on a citizen. My therapist is one of the most beautiful, wonderful women that I have ever met in my life. Her name's Aisha, she's from Homewood. She knows how these races work, and she knows how this system is geared against the poor and geared against the voiceless. And she told me, she said, they put their hands on you again, I'm gonna go talk to that judge and tell them what they've done to you. And the amount of abuse that has occurred here is over the top. It's over the top. And they think that they can do this with impunity to people. They believe that I have no civil rights. They believe that I have no human rights. They believe that because I'm a dissident towards their system, that they can just do and hurt and abuse me any which way they choose to, while pretending that the Constitution still exists, while pretending that I still have civil rights, while pretending that I still have human rights. And they say, no, he has rights, Look, we're doing this the right way. As they manipulate the system to hurt and abuse me even more and more, knowing that I'm the victim of gang sexual assault, knowing I'm the victim of an attempted murder by the police, knowing that I'm the victim of systemic abuse and torture. I mean, these are things that are on the record. These are things that anybody can go to the courthouse or to the county building and get the transcripts of how they tortured me in this building for 42 days with no charges or no violations. And when I don't break the law, and when I exercise my rights of the law, they will find any excuse to lock me back up like they just did. And when I stand up for my rights and I say, you're not going to abuse me, they say, oh yeah, watch us abuse you again. When I say, I am not going to stand the abuse that you inflict upon innocent people, they say, oh really, what are you going to do about it? Watch what we do now to you. So it is time that enough is enough, and there's Burnett said. This cannot continue in America. This cannot continue and still be a place of constitution. And there cannot be a Bill of Rights. And this is allowed to be accepted as normal, right? And this is worse than Russia. This is worse than what they did to Nadia. This is worse than what they do to people in Russia. The living conditions in the prisons, in Russian prisons, are so much better than the living conditions in here. This is one of the most violent, disgusting, foul places on earth. And they continue to blame me, the victim, and say that we're gonna hurt you more until you submit. We're gonna hurt you more until you give up. We're gonna keep hurting you, Joshua, until you accept that there's nothing you can do about it. And I will not accept that. I will not, as an American citizen, and as someone who believes in the Constitution and the Bill of Rights, accept the fact that this is normal in America, because those pigs belong in here for the rest of their fucking lives. And I'm going to make sure, one way or the other, that justice is served. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. I love you, and let's keep on rocking and rolling on the radio.